trouble to pirate American television.
Day 1317. In my predecessor's files, I discovered a contact with the Agency, a shadow American organization with their final fingers in every pie. As I await to meet this mysterious figure with his cowboy drawl, my gaze.
Sure you want to do this?
Day 1341. I saw disgraced ex-General DeLuca fishing off the pier. What a pitiful sight. The man wastes the precious oxygen of this earth. But I owe it to him to find one more use for his life. That Agency man I met might be the key. I need only set the wheels in motion.
Out there!
Panic!
target is still at large. Find him.
One town at a time.
Day 1349. One can conjure insanity within a subject. It just takes a bit of a sense of humor. The agency contact merely orchestrated some pranks on DeLuca, burning toast in his house while he's away, moving the dock he likes to fish at by a few feet, calling and saying nothing on the phone. Just enough mischief for him to begin to question his senses.
These schools are gone for good. I'm going to try.
1977. After weeks of adjusting to Luca's perceptions, the psychological cracks widened. He reacted violently to a local constable who received a tip that DeLuca was fishing without a license. When he showed the license, which we replaced with an obvious fake drawn by a child, he flew into a rage. He kept shouting that this was all part of an elaborate conspiracy.
Where the action is.
1385. Sergeant Major Dusku's role in the plan to create an enemy force within Metagy began today. A forged audio message reached Dusku last night, pleading for help, saying that there exists a conspiracy to ruin the sovereignty of Metagy. Dusku, in his typical patriotic zeal, immediately made plans to visit former General DeLuca. The seeds of a rebellion take root and need but a little light and water to grow.
Someone report. What's the situation? Have we lost him? Report.
Silo. We decided it would be safest just to destroy the whole base. That mold stuff can be pretty nasty. So much destruction, but it's all for the greater good, isn't it? Maintaining the status quo, a stable and strong nation. Viva Metagy. Thank you.
Looks like it could be valuable.
Day 1492. Much time has passed since my last entry. Tusku's arrest warrant lingers, but remains uninvestigated. The Policia searched Luca's dust-covered home and found no evidence of where he disappeared to. The case file rests in an unresolved stack. With some gentle nudging, the two of them sailed to a small hideout in the far southern tip of the islands, building...
Thank you for everything.
I'm going to go to the hospital.
your honor. Investigation into the disappearance of DeLuca rested with a pointless young officer, a reckless youth who races cars. A small service today commemorated the young officer's death in a tragic accident.
His brakes inexplicably failed
on the NASCAR. An amateur racer, Rico Rodriguez, won the race, barely avoiding the accident himself. Another career begun in triumph and tragedy.
Reports a limousine en route to pick up a Di Ravello informant. Steal the limo and proceed with the pickup, impersonating the driver.
For idealism. With a little more time, violence against the innocent is inevitable.
Engaging the target. All units converge on the following coordinates. This is dispatch. Request received. Reinforcements en route. Additional ground forces to your location immediately.
36. A new threat rises. Rosa Manuela, a little-known politician, created quite a stir with her recent speech decrying the corruption of government and the military elite. She foments dissent in a way that proves contrary to my needs. 15:51, a bomb exploded in the small town of Soliana, killing a few fishermen and injuring a dozen others.
DeLuca's
military mind proves useful, though his personal grudges makes the targets he chooses predictable.
An artifact. Parking space.
Jeez! Rico, our savior, thank you for everything you do.
thanks you for your sacrifice.